Today topic, we want to learn if one is allowed to sell jewelry with cross or things along those lines. You have all kind of jewelry that, let's say, you have a mother with a baby in the stomach, which refers to Jesus and his mother, and so on. All kind of jewelry like that. Are you permitted to sell such things? First, we'll see if the cross itself is Avodah Zarah. Would you consider a cross Avodah Zarah? Now, there's many, many tshuvot that were written about this topic. Chacham Ovadia has also tshuvot on this topic in few sfarim, Alichot Olam, in Yabia Omer Chelek Bet and Chelek Yud, and in Alichot Olam in Chelek Zayin. He speaks about a different case. He speaks about somebody, let's say, bought by mistake a gown that had many cross on it, that was a gown that belonged to a priest. And now he wants to know if he's allowed to sell it to a priest. Can he keep it? What should he do with it? Another question that he has is a person that was given a cross from the government or from the high priest, like the Pope, as some kind of something that shows importance. Can he wear it when he has a meeting with those governments? They're expecting them to wear it because they gave it to him as a gift, and he comes over there and he's not going to wear it. It doesn't look good. So can he wear it? And the discussion goes along this line that the Rama says that it is, first of all, Avodah Zarah. You need to realize that a cross is Avodah Zarah. Why is that? Because the definition of Avodah Zarah is something that one either bows down to it, or let's say he shechts a korban to it, he pours to it, right? Like nesech, menasech.
What about kissing?
So kissing we'll see in a second, because there's a chelkat Yaakov in Yored Asiman Nun Gimel that we'll see that he says that as well, kissing and hugging it and this kind of behavior towards it also is considered Avodah Zarah. But right now the definition of Avodah Zarah is one of those things that we explained, and therefore doing bowing down to the cross would create the Avodah Zarah, and therefore such a thing would be Asur Be'ana'ah. One is not allowed to benefit from it. If a goy ever bowed down to it, it would be Asur Be'ana'ah. And where do we find such a thing? First of all, we do find in the Shulchan Aruch in few places that it speaks about a cross. Now, many Shulchan Aruch, if you look inside, would not have that word because the censor took it out. Because it was dangerous living in European countries. Jews were always prosecuted, so they took it out. But for instance, in Shulchan Aruch, Siman, Kuf Yud Gimel, Seif Chet, it says the following. Amit Palel. A person that is in the middle of Tfilat Shmoneh Esreh, uva goy kenegdo, a goy is passing by him, ve'yesh lo shti ve'erev, and he walks with Avodah Zarah, a cross right on his neck. Ve'igia lemakom shochi, but now he's in front of you, and you're right by modim, so you need to bow down. You're allowed to bow down. It says the halacha lo yischa, af al pi shelibo l'shamayim. You do not bow down, even though you mean for Kadosh Baruch Hu. That's Asur. So you see that the Lashon, again, not every Shulchan Aruch would have this word, Shti Ve'erev, but in the old prints, and today they bring the map also, the Lashon is Ve'yesh lo Shti Ve'erev. He has a cross. Shti Ve'erev is a cross. So you see that the Halacha looks at it as Avodah Zarah Mamash. And this is how it's brought down in the Mefarshim as well, that it's Asur Mishum Avodah Zarah. If you take a look at the Rama that we'll be dealing with a lot today, and that's a Rama in Siman Kuf Mem Aleph in Yoreh De'ah, where he speaks about Hilchot Avodah Zarah. There's a whole section of Avodah Zarah over there. Over there he says that Tzurat Shti Ve'erev Yesh Lo Din Avodah Zarah. It has a law, it has the din, it has, it's considered Avodah Zarah. And therefore, one that sees a cross, it becomes problematic. First of all, if it is Avodah Zarah, then one is not allowed to look at it. Because you're not allowed to look at Avodah Zarah. It says in the Torah, Al tifnu ele elilim. And there's machloket, Rashi Tosfot, in the Gemara Shabbat. What does it mean? Either it means that you should not be pone to something, as Rashi learned, something that you yourself created. So a person that creates something, one is not allowed to look at it. So that's a hard perush, let's say a painting, let's say something along those lines. Rashi would be strict about it. But Tosfot says, no, it means avodah zarah. One is not allowed to look. Al tifnu el elilim, not al tifnu el midatchem. What does it mean, al tifnu el midatchem, that the Gemara says? What does it mean? Tosfot learns that you're not allowed to look at avodah zarah. And therefore, if you have a cross that was worshipped, that's considered avodah zarah, you're not allowed to look at it. You're not allowed to be in the same house with the avodah zarah. So let's say they worshipped the avodah zarah, and
if it's a brand new one.
So we get to it. We're talking right now, first, that you worshipped, somebody worshipped that cross, it becomes avodah zarah. And he has all kind of halachot implications that one would not be allowed to do all the kind of things around it. One of the things we saw here, you're not allowed to bow down and when he passes by you. Another thing, you're not allowed to walk in a house that has avodah zarah, and so on. We'll get to all the details.
For the necklace that's hanging.
1 minute, we'll get to the necklace. Now, when we're getting to the necklace, says the Rema in that same place, in Siman Kuf Mem Aleph, Seif Aleph, he says that it depends what was the cross made and was it worshipped or not. If the cross was not worshipped, then it doesn't have din avodah zarah and it's not forbidden. Now, if you take a look at Rav Moshe, Rav Moshe has a tshuva, for instance, in Igrot Moshe, Yoreh De'asamechtet. He writes that if you have a stamp, now it's very common by stamps to have a cross on a stamp, and it's not only by a stamp. You'll find that sometimes a shirt has a symbol of a cross on the tag, and you'll find other things, like cars, for instance, that have a cross, and so on and so forth. You have many things today that they put a cross, and you bring it into your house, and you're allowed to do such a thing. So Moshe says that there's no issur on it, since they didn't worship that very thing that you're buying. Let's say you bought a stamp. Can you use it? He says there's no issur, because nobody worshipped that stamp. And therefore, although it symbolizes avodah zarah, but it's not asur. He even says that it's not asur to look at it, because it's not avodah zarah. So therefore, there's no issur to look at it. Others would argue to say, 1 minute, that symbolizes avodah zarah. Other places, they would use that as avodah zarah. It should be asur as well over here. Like, for instance, I'll give you an example. They have all kind of pictures and drawings and movies of what they call Jesus. Right? So they have a certain figure that they considering that figure Jesus. So that's avodah zarah. Why is he avodah zarah? Because people worship him. People worship him, they worship his, they consider him a god, and therefore, if you look at such a thing, that should be asur. Or you would say, well, wait, it's only a picture, nobody ever bowed down to that picture, it should be mutar. That comes into that argument. Now, when we come into our discussion, says,
we think,
yes,
whatever picture they have of him is thought up of in an artist's mind, because there are no real pictures of Yashka.
Yeah, every avodah zarah starts in the artist's mind, and they created it into avodah zarah. That's the whole idea of avodah zarah. It doesn't have any reality to it. It's all made up. It says, Derema Siman Kuf Mem Aleph, Shti Ve'erev, Shetolim Be'tzavar, you put on the necklace, Lezikaron, to remind them the avodah zarah. What do they do with this? It reminds them of avodah zarah. Lo mikri tzelem umutar. It's not considered avodah zarah. It's permitted. That is what the Rema brings down la halacha. Which means you have two kinds of crosses. One that was worshipped and one that was not worshipped. So if it's not worshipped, why are they buying it? Lezikaron, to remind them about the avodah zarah. They like to wear it, and they're very religious, and they, with that, remember the avodah zarah. They get inspired, whatever it is, but they never actually worshipped it. Says the Rema, it's not asur, lo mikri tzelem umutar. And this is how we found in the Motchi, the Ravya, and in the Levush as well, in the same Siman Kuf Mem Aleph. This is how the Bach brings, and many poskim. Now, over here, the discussion, if you take a look at all the Sfarim that speak about this, it's all the same discussion, that the Shach says that when you get something, you don't know if it was worshipped or not. And if you don't know, you need to be strict because it's a safek deoraita. Whenever you have a safek and you don't know, you have to be strict and you're not allowed to benefit from it. Unless you know for sure that that wasn't worship. This is how the Shach says halacha lemaase. But many poskim argue on the Shach, the Zera Emet. The Chacham Ovadia brings a list of poskim that argue on the Shach, and they say, no, you need to know that it was worshipped. Or at least, in our case, that we know that something is brand new, you know for sure that it wasn't worshipped. So you can look at it also in such an aspect to say, 1 minute, that's brand new, I'm buying something in order to sell. I'm buying merchandise, I'm selling that merchandise. It came from the manufacturer, nobody ever worshipped it, for sure not. What do you think, they take each and every piece before they sell it and they bow down to it? Since they don't do that, it's not considered Avodah Zarah. So with that Mahalach, that at least it becomes a Safek, Chacham Ovadia builds a fake Sfeika and he permits it. Others would say that it should be Mutar because that's good enough to say that something like that is not Asur. I'm reading you now the Chelkat Yaakov that wrote a Tshuva on this. And many poskim bring him down, and he be'etzem says he goes a little bit to be more strict. Now, just to give you the bottom line, that what we're trying to get to, and that is what the poskim hold. Are you allowed to sell those crosses or you're not? So the poskim, it seems like across the board saying that it's not Avodah Zarah, and therefore, since it's brand new, it wasn't worshipped, and therefore there's no issur of Avodah Zarah. There's no issur also, according to most poskim, there's no issur also of marit ayin, or that people should look at it and say, look, he's selling Avodah Zarah, unlike the Chelkat Yaakov that was machmir in this. And the reason it's not marit ayin is because people know, anybody that passes by knows that it's not Avodah Zarah, and therefore it's not asur. Mishum marit ayin, mishum chashad, mishum that it looks bad. The Chelkat Yaakov was machmir more, as he says that it's not the correct thing to do. And I'm reading you right now the understanding of most of the poskim, why still you shouldn't use it. So the Chelkat Yaakov and Rav Eliashiv as well writes, and you can see this in Ashreish, in the beginning of Hilchot Avodah Zarah, that we're afraid that if you sell it, the person buying it would worship it. And if he does, then you're violating Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Michshol, because you bring that and you make it available for the buyer to have something that they worship. Now, that's a discussion. He's allowed to worship. He's not allowed to worship. Are you allowed to worship Avodah Zarah? Goy is commanded on one of the Sheva Mitzvot Bnei Noach is not to worship Avodah Zarah. So Christianity, we spoke in the past, has three problems. One is Avodah Zarah, they worship idols. That's definitely a suh for goyish to worship idols, and we're not allowed to promote it in any way. And secondly, they have a problem of apikorsut, which means they change what the Torah says, which is also one of the things that they're not allowed to do. The set of things that they're allowed to do, the set of things they're not allowed to do. It's written in the Rambam, in the end of Hilchot Melachim. One of the things they're not allowed to do is change what the Torah says. They're not allowed to do that. They take a Bible, they change the altar, and they alter the Torah, they put things that it doesn't say over there, and they explain whatever it says in the Torah in different lights, in things that are considered apikorsut. And we explain that apikorsut means anybody that takes the message of God and he
either distorts
it, or he says that he doesn't believe in it, or whatever he does with the message has to stay the way it is authentic. And min, the Rambam explains, is not somebody that has a problem with the message of God, but rather he has a problem with the God. What does it mean? It means that you say that this Rambam explains, in Ilchot Tshuva, he brings, what's it mean? Somebody that says that there's more than one God. Somebody that feels that God has a shape. Somebody that feels that the God has a messenger. Somebody that feels that there's more than one God, we said that, right? Christians have all that. They have Trinity, they have three Godheads, they have a God that has a shape, that's Jesus. They have all these problems. And therefore, they considered Minim, Apikorsim, and Avodei Avodah Zarah as well. This is how Rav Shtanbuch writes in Tshuvot V'Anagot, that they also considered Avodei Avodah Zarah. So do you come?
Would we do overall of the halakha? Do we prefer that they are Christians or atheists?
Well, atheists, they're not of the Avodah Zarah. So the goy is metzuveh in sheva mitzvot. He doesn't have a mitzvah to believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. A Jew has a mitzvah to believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Now, a goy is not going to be, according to the Rambam, it's not considered chassid umot ha'olam unless he does whatever he does, not because it's the correct thing to do, not because it's moral, but rather because God commanded so. And therefore, he needs to believe that God commanded so in order to perform those Sheva Mitzvot B'nei Noach. But he doesn't have a positive commandment like Jews have that you have to believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So therefore, an atheist is not the end of the world. Definitely, Oved Avodah Zarah is something that's not permitted. Now, when we're talking about, we're coming back to our discussion of Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol. What does it mean, Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol? It means that you're not allowed to put a stumble block in front of a blind person. That's what it means literally. But the Chachamim explained to us that it doesn't mean only that. It means also that, but it means much more than that. And that is of bringing somebody close to doing Avera. You present a person with the Avera, that's considered Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol. So the example to that it says in the Gemara in Avodah Zarah, beginning of Avodah Zarah, if you give, let's say, somebody that's not allowed to eat something, you give him a piece that's Asur. For instance, for a Nazir, you give him wine. For a Goy, you give him Ever Minachai, and so on and so forth. Those people are not allowed to eat those things. You made it accessible for them. You brought it to them. You handed it to them. That's asur mishum lifnei iver lo titen mikshol.
To do a cross?
That's the we'll see. We're getting to it. 1 minute. So now, when you are handing somebody a isur and you know that what he's going to do with it is a isur, that's the reason he's buying it. If a person you want to give him a horse and he's planning to eat that horse, you're violating Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol. A person is not allowed to eat a horse, not a kosher animal. But if somebody comes to you and tells you, I want to buy a horse, you're allowed to sell him a horse. Why? Because horses are not made to eat. Horses are made to ride on them. So therefore, you don't have to suspect. But if somebody tells you, can you make me a bacon hamburger? Right? So what do you think he's going to do with a bacon hamburger? Obviously eat it. And therefore, you're not allowed to make it for him and hand it him. It's called Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol. When we're talking about giving a goy right now a cross, you're giving him a cross and you suspect that he might worship that cross, that could be a problem. So Rabbi Yashiv says, therefore, you're not allowed to sell jewelry with crosses because you're making it available for the goy, when he buys it for you, to worship that cross. And but he says that if a person already bought, he has merchandise already, he has a stock already, so then he's allowed to sell it. Why? We'll see in a second what's the reason to permit it. Because the Gemara explains that Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol is only if you can bring it close to him. But if he can have it otherwise, which means what the Gemara says, the difference between Chad Avre De Nahara and Tre Avre De Nahara. What's Tre Avre De Nahara? There's a river in between you and him, and he tells you, do me a favor, I need the hamburger. He's a Jew, he's not a goy. Yeah, I need the hamburger. Can you hand it to him? The isur of that will be Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol, because if not, if you don't hand it to him, he doesn't have it. He can't have it. It's not available for him. It's on the other side of the river. But if it's on the same side of the river and he tells you, do me a favor, I'm too lazy to get up from my seat, just can you hand it to me? You sit near him, it's on the other side. Can you hand it to him? If you hand it to him, you're not violating Lifnei Iver Lo Titen Mikshol. So what are you violating? Really, it's a machloket rishonim. Tosfot in the beginning of Shabbat says one thing, and in Avodah Zarah they say a different thing. The many rishonim hold that you're violating mesayah. What's mesayah? You're helping somebody do a isur. Isur of mesayah is only the rabbanan. It's not the oraita. It's not Deoraita. Mm-hmm. And therefore, since it's only Isur de Rabbanan, sometimes there would be leniencies to that Isur. For example, the Shach brings, and this is how the Gulmer Vava explains, that it's permitted to give somebody who's a mumar, we spoke in the past what's a mumar, somebody that violates the Torah regularly, he doesn't care about a certain avera or all averot, somebody that's mumar, you don't have a isur mesayah for such a person. You have a isur of lifnei iver, but you don't have a isur mesayah. Again, Avraham in Milchot Eruvin argues on that. He says that there is a isur mesayah. But you have over here a isur mesayah. When we're talking about selling a goy, definitely you don't have a isur of mesayah. This is how the Chelkat Yaakov brings it down. Let's just see it inside. He says, "Achen isur ze shelifnei iver no rak betre avre de nara." The isur is not only when it's a river in between, which means you are in two different sides of the river. Ve'af beYisrael yesh gam ken isur mishum meseya lidei ovrei avera. You have a isur to help somebody violate the Torah. Ve'ze isur gam bechad avre de nara. We call that isur. What? Mesayah. Alo yadu ha-shitat ha-shach, kuf nun alef, de be-Israel mumar leka isur mesayah. In Israel, that violates the Torah, constantly, is considered mumar, there's no isur of mesayah. And Avnei Nezer explains the reason, is because the isur of lafrish somebody from isur, to make somebody stay away from isur, see somebody that wants to make isur, you have to try to prevent him from it, that's because of arvut. You have arvut, you are connected with each person in Israel. And arvut is learned, mikashlu ish be'achiv. That's how it says in Shavuot Lametet Amud Aleph. And therefore, since he is not considered achicha b'mitzvot, imcha b'mitzvot, is not, doesn't have the same connection that you do to the mitzvot of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, there's no issue of Messiah. Umumar shemutar lo alvoto beribit, mitam de lo ave achiv, kamvuar beramban, and so on and so forth, mimele eno bechlal arvut de lemedim meachiv. Okay? But he says all that is true when we have Israel kasher, and not Israel mumar, and definitely when we're talking about a goy, you don't have Isur Messiah. So therefore, if that goy wants to buy from you a cross, you have a shop and you sell crosses. He wants to come and buy from you a cross. Says the halacha that it depends if he could buy it somewhere else or only from you. Mm-hmm. If he could buy it somewhere else, so there's no isur of lifnei iver, and since there's no isur of lifnei iver, there's also no isur of mesayah, that's isur de rabbanan, because he's less than a mumar, he's a goy. Therefore, it would be permitted to sell him, right? Now, where's the avodah zarah that you're doing, that he's doing with the cross? I don't think that, I don't know, but I don't think they take that cross that they bought to put on the chain and they put it on the counter and they start bowing down to it and praying to it. I don't think that's what they do. That's what they do maybe in their churches. They have all kind of big crosses like this that they bow down to it, could be. But not those little crosses that the Rama says, it's a zikaron be'alma. So he says, the Chelkat Yaakov, a chidush. Not everybody agrees to it. It's pretty much his chidush. And he says the following. First of all, he says many people do bow down to it. He says that's the fact and reality today. He didn't live a long time ago. So he says, No. Chelkat Yaakov is a Rav Breish. Av Bet Din Tzirich. So he says, V'cheni gam emetziyut, D'yadinan sh'arbe mehem, Kodem achila o sheina, before they eat, before they sleep, menashkim u'mitpalelim l'toevot ha'elu. They pray to it and they kiss it. Now, if you ever take a look, somebody told me that, and I was surprised because I never saw it before. I have a friend that lives across the street from a church, and he says that whenever a Christian passes by a church, he starts making that hand shape around his heart, right? Or making a shape of a cross, and he stands over there in awe and fear. So I never seen it before, but since then I started looking what happens when a goy passes a church, and I did see that. That's very, very. So you see that they have such a thing, as he explains over here, the Chelkat Yaakov, that when they see a religious item, or they see a religious thing, they would treat it with much respect, and even, he says, they would kiss it, and sometimes bow to it, and pray to it, which is, he says over here, could be, according to his understanding, a form of worshipping Avodah Zarah. And according to that, we're running into a question: when you sell that to the goy, what would he do with it? He might kiss it, he might hug it, he might say some words of praying to it. And therefore, you are helping him over the isur of worshipping idols, which he is not allowed to do. He's chayav mitah for such a thing. It's a serious violation of the Torah. And therefore, you're not allowed to help him out do these things. So, if he can buy it somewhere else, they sell that same thing somewhere else, so then you're not violating anything, as we explained before, because it's uchad avra de nahara. Sometimes, it's not so easy to buy somewhere else. He comes to your shop, and he knows that that's what he wants to buy from you, either because he likes the price, he likes the service, otherwise he's not going to buy somewhere else. What Avodah Zarah means, as I explained before, is either bowing down to it, or doing another form of the three other ways of doing Avodah Zarah, which is, which will be all considered halachically not permitted, not only for a Jew, but also for a goy. The halacha, the zalachot, not only for Jews, but also for goy. A goy has to keep Sheva Mitzvot Bnei Noach. One of the Sheva Mitzvot Bnei Noach by a goy is worshipping idols. He's not allowed. And if he does, he violates one of the Sheva Mitzvot Bnei Noach. And I'm not allowed to help him violate the Isur of the Torah. Where do I find that I'm not allowed to help him in the Isur of Lifnei Iver? That Gemara of Avodah Zarah Daf Zayin that says that a Moshit Ever Minachai Leben Noach, if I hand to the Goy Ever Minachai a limb from an animal that was that was living and somebody cut a piece of that limb, that's called Ever Minachai. You have, let's say, a cow. And you just ripped the ear from the cow. You took a knife and you ripped it just when she was alive. That's called Ever Minachai. Now you want to barbecue it and give it to a goy. That's not permitted. It's asur for him to eat Ever Minachai. If I mix it...
I agree.
Yes. So therefore, being Oved Avodah Zarah for goy is not permitted. Our shiur is not intended for goyim, should they worship idols or not. Our shiur is intended for Jewish people, that many are... in the diamond district, in the gold district, in the gold business, in the whatever it is. And therefore, the question comes, are they allowed to sell those things or not? So they would say, the halakha would say, according to majority of the poskim, if you take a look at the Zkan Aharon, if you take a look at Chacham Ovadia, in Chazon Ovadia, in Yabi HaOmer, you take a look at Rav Eliashiv that I mentioned before, you take a look at Chelkat Yaakov, and so on and so forth. Many poskim that speak about it, many, they all say the same idea, or mostly say the same idea, that lechatchila you shouldn't sell it, because either it doesn't look good. Although you're not violating maybe the isur of maritain or chashad, people are not going to suspect you of anything, because if the halacha permits selling it, so it's not going to cause suspicion. But it doesn't look good that a goy makes his living with something like that, something that has to do with Azara.
A Jew.
A Jew, he said.